So in the last video we started with motion in straight line and we did some formula of speed and velocity, average speed, average velocity, instantaneous speed and instantaneous velocity. Now today in this video we are going to discuss about vector and scalar quantities, and we will study only that much vector quantity which is required right now for this chapter. Later on there are other aspects related to vector that will come later on. I will make another video for that. So for quickly we'll do this in very short. There are two types of physical quantities, scalar and vector. Scalar quantities are those quantities which are defined by magnitude only, while vector quantities are those quantities which are defined by magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction both, that means we have to use them both at the same time, not one by one. So examples: magnitude only, speed is a scalar quantity. Speed equals to 50 meter per second. What does it tell? It just tells us the magnitude of the speed, the size of the speed, the exact value. What is the absolute value of the speed? It does not tell us in which direction the body is going. So it is defined, speed is defined by the magnitude only, so it is a scalar quantity. Another example, distance. What is distance? Distance is the total length of the path. Okay, it is the total length, it does not depend on the direction. If we are given the distance is 10 meter, then this 10 meter can be path length in any direction. It does not even have to be straight, it can be curved also. It is also possible that the body is going from one point to another and then coming back. Suppose a body started from point A, it went 5 meter to point B and then returned from here 3 meters to point C. So what will be the total distance? Total distance is the total length of path. What is the total length of path? A to B plus B to C. So 5 plus 3, so the distance will be equal to 8 meters. It does not depend upon the direction. We do not care whether the body was first going in this direction and then coming back. It does not matter when we are calculating distance. So distance is a scalar quantity. Now let us quickly come to the vector. Vector is a quantity defined by magnitude as well as direction. Example, velocity. Now velocity, if I write velocity 50 meter per second, now I have a speed of 50 meter per second and I have a velocity of 50 meter per second. Now if I do not tell you the direction here in this velocity, while saying that 50 meter per second and I do not tell you the direction, then this is not velocity, this becomes equal to speed. If we have to categorize a certain speed in terms of velocity, then we have to give the direction also, and this direction can be anything. It is not compulsory that we have to use northeast, southwest or northeast, southwest, southeast. That is not compulsory. Any direction, upward, downward, towards A, towards O, towards positive x axis, towards negative y axis, all of these are directions. I can say that the truck is coming at a speed of 50 meter per second towards me. That is also a direction because I am specifying in which direction the truck is moving. It is moving towards me. So then it becomes velocity. If I do not tell the direction, then it is a speed. So 50 meter per second, let us say, towards north. Okay, just for the example, I am writing towards north. Another example of vector quantity, displacement. Now there is a difference between distance and displacement. Distance is total path length. Displacement is shortest distance between initial and final position. So the distance depends upon the total path, total length of the path. It does not depend on the direction. Total length of the path, A to B and then B to C, 8 meters. It depends on the shortest distance between initial and final point. So when we are talking about displacement, we are not concerned about the
path length. We are just concerned about the initial and final positions of the body. So if we take this same example, the body starts from A, it goes to B, covering a distance of 5 meter. Now notice my words very carefully, covering a distance of 5 meter, and then it is coming back to C, covering a distance of 3 meter. So what will be the distance? Distance will be equal to 8 meter, that is clear. What will be the displacement? Displacement will be the shortest distance between initial and final position. What is the shortest distance between initial and final position? It is 5 minus 3. We just need this much distance. This is the shortest. This is the initial position. This is the final position. So this is your displacement. This will be equal to 5 minus 3, 2 meter. So this is how distance and displacement are different. There are some cases when distance and displacement will be same. For example, if the body is going from A to B and stopping there, then what is the distance? A to B, 5 meter. What is the displacement? A to B, 5 meter, because it is a straight line. There is no shortest distance. The shortest distance is equal to the actual distance in this case. So in this particular case, distance and displacement will be equal to each other. But in any other case, displacement will be the shortest distance between initial and final position. It's a very important thing. And distance is the total path length. Now this is the scalar and vector quantity. Now let us come to vector notation. From now on, we are going to use vector sign also to tell whether a given quantity is vector or scalar. So if I say, we did the formula yesterday, we did speed, average speed was total distance upon total time. Total distance upon total time. This was the average speed. I should write like this, other you will confuse V with velocity. Average speed. What will be average velocity? It will be equal to total displacement upon total time. So this is the general formula, but when we are writing velocity, we have to tell that the velocity is a vector. How do we tell that? We use vector notation. Vector notation means way to write a vector. So let us say that if there is a vector A, there is A and it is a vector, it will be written like this. There will be an arrow towards right. It is always towards right, not left, not upward. It is always towards right. So this will signify vector A. If I just write A, no vector sign, then it will signify a scalar quantity. So remember, now you have to make it a habit to do this, to write this notation. So if I write average speed equals to this and this is V, there is no vector sign, so that means this is speed. But if I write it like this, then it becomes velocity. So now we have to keep in mind, we have to be very careful about the vector notation, otherwise the meaning will change. So this is a vector notation. Suppose we have two vectors, A and B, both starting from the same point but going in different direction. So there will be one vector, say A, going like this, and another vector B going like this. How will we write this? This will be vector A and this will be vector B. Force is a vector quantity. So if I write that a force of 30 Newton is applied, if I write this, then this is a scalar quantity. I have to mention the direction. And if I am saying that 30 Newton equals to force, then how do I have to write F? I have to write it like this to tell that the force is a vector quantity. If I do not use this notation, that means I am just telling you the magnitude part and I am not telling you the direction. But the direction is very important in vector quantities. So we will write the other formula that we used. We used instantaneous speed. So we will write V equals to, it was dx by dt. Yes, it was dx by dt. This is the speed. How do we know that? There is no vector sign here. What is instantaneous velocity? It is also equal to dx by dt, but this is a
vector quantity. So what do I have to do? I have to put an arrow here, and also we know that it is equal to total displacement. Displacement is also a vector quantity, so I have to put a vector sign here. So this will become your instantaneous speed and this will become your instantaneous velocity. Okay, so I hope this is clear. This is how we are going to use notation. Now there are certain other aspects related to the vector also: addition of vector, subtraction of vector, multiplications of vector. So that I will make a separate video when we need them. So in the next video we'll start with the acceleration.